Hi, and welcome to this talk on what you can achieve with a tummy tuck. I'm Dr. John Paletta from the Georgia Institute for Plastic Surgery in Savannah, Georgia. When patients come to me and they want to talk about their abdomen, usually the things that we're talking about, tummy tucks, liposuction, or the combination of the two procedures, but we're going to focus on just what a tummy tuck does today. And the typical patient who has a tummy tuck are usually patients who have had significant weight loss or patients who have undergone pregnancy, one or multiple pregnancies. So what happens with those situations? Well, first of all, the skin gets stretched out, right? That happens with pregnancy, that happens with weight gain. And then after pregnancy or after you lose weight, the skin comes back, but not all the ways back. So you have that loose skin, it hangs over. And the other thing that happens is, particularly with pregnancy, the muscles, which are here in the middle, the rectus muscles, they spread apart. And when they come back, they don't come all the way back. There's a little bit of space, what we call rectus diastasis. And that causes the, even somebody who's very thin and fit, the belly to pooch forward because the muscles are a little bit loose. So what does a tummy tuck achieve? A tummy tuck removes all the extra skin. Okay. It removes any extra fat that could be in the bottom part of the abdomen. It doesn't treat extra fat in the upper part. It doesn't treat any extra fat along the sides, but along the bottom part of the belly where the extra skin is being removed. And lastly, it tightens the muscles. A lot of patients who have had pregnancy, they may be at their pre-pregnancy weight or even lighter and their belly looks different, and tightening that muscle could be a very key component to that. Now, how do we decide what's the best incision? There are versions of tummy tucks. There's a so-called mini tummy tuck, which is a little bit wider than a C-section scar, you know, but it stays in the front. And then you can have a standard tummy tuck, which is basically about from hip bone to hip bone. You can have what's called an extended tummy tuck, where the incision will go back towards the back, okay? And then you can have what's called an around the world or a belt lipectomy or a lower body lift, where the incision goes all the ways around and meets in the back. And there's different advantages and disadvantages. The key thing is to assess, where do you have loose skin? You know, if you don't have much loose skin in the back or on the sides, then an around the world is not going to be the option for you. If you just have a little tiny bit right in the front, then maybe a mini tummy tuck is the best option. And of course, you need an in-person consultation with a board-certified plastic surgeon to make that determination. One thing that you might be able to do at home is if you can grab skin and you can pull it up and you can see the outer part of the thigh gets smoother, if you grab skin on the back and pull it up and the shape of the buttocks gets better, that's typically somebody who would benefit from an around the world. But again, the best thing is to see your plastic surgeon and have an in-person consultation so you can go over those risks and benefits of those procedures. Thank you.